Hello and welcome to this video tutorial from Computergaga.com. And in this video, we are going to learn how to hyperlink to a hidden worksheet. So imagine this scenario. I have this main sheet at the bottom here, and I've also got a sheet for each fruit of apples, oranges, pears, and pineapples. And on this main sheet, I have a kind of table of contents, if you will, which links to each of those other sheets. And at the moment, that's going to work fine because I've already taken the effort of selecting these cells, doing the Control K keyboard shortcut, and setting up a hyperlink to the other sheet. So they're going to work absolutely fine. If I click on pears, it takes me to pears. If I click on apples, it takes me to apples. And I've also got a link on each of those sheets in cell A1 that just takes me back to main, and that's going to work fine too. But what if one of those sheets was hidden? If I was to right mouse click and hide the pairs sheet and then go and try the hyperlink on main, then it's not going to work. And we need it to. So this is going to take a little bit of VBA, and we're going to get that working. So let me click on my developer tab at the top on the ribbon and click Visual Basic to get into the Visual Basic editor. And we're not going to need a module for this. We're going to need to write some code in the worksheets themselves, because we're going to run it off an event. This macro is going to run off an event. So I'm going to double click on the Sheet 1 window here. Now, I actually don't need to at the moment because I'm actually already there. I can see at the top on the title bar, it says Sheet 1 code, and Sheet 1 is the main sheet in this case. But you would simply double click that if that's not the case. That would open up the appropriate code window. In the first drop down list, I would choose worksheet, and in the second drop down list, I'm going to choose a different event or procedure. So it defaults to the selection change event when dealing with worksheets, but the one that I want is going to be the follow hyperlink event. So if somebody clicks a hyperlink on that sheet. So the actual name of the event, follow hyperlink, is a little bit misleading. It just means if clicked on it. It's not actually going to perform the follow, which you'll see very shortly. So that's going to put that sub on here. So we're not going to change the name of this. It's essential for it to work. We'll leave that well alone. But we do have the sub. We've now got to write the code that's going to actually unhide the kind of destination of the hyperlink sheet and then actually move ourselves to it. So there's two bits of information that we need to know. We need to know which link was clicked and then where is that link going, so that we're able to unhide the right sheet and take ourselves to it. Now, the first bit of information is already given to us. They're telling us that target, this parameter, this argument, is the hyperlink that was clicked. So we can just refer to it as target. That's been given to us. But we need to know, where is that link going? Because otherwise, we're not going to unhide the right sheet. Now, I'm going to demonstrate two different ways of doing this. Now, just before I start this, if I go back to the worksheet, one thing I'd like to point out is the names of the links, like apples, oranges, pears, are the same as the name of the worksheet. So my first technique is just to say, look, whatever the hyperlink's called, the sheet's exactly the same name. Just go to that sheet. And then I'm going to show a second example of being able to ascertain the address of the link. Because for you guys, the sheet might not be the same name as the clickable kind of text. So I'm going to show you two different ways. One thing I am going to start with is I'm going to declare a string variable. Now, if you're quite new to VBA, I'll have a link in the description of this video to my online VBA course, so you become a badass in VBA pretty quick. But for those of you who have a little bit more experience, this should be quite commonplace what I'm doing at the moment. I'm declaring a variable called sheet name, SHT name, and it's string because it's going to handle text, aka the name of the sheet. I'm then going to assign to it, and I'm going to assign target, the link that was clicked, and when I put in my period, this full stop, it will list the different properties and methods available to me. And I want to start with one called name. So the name of the link, which as I mentioned a few moments ago, is the same as the name of the sheet. So for me, in this example, that would work very well. But I'm going to come back to that with another example in a moment. Next up though, now that we've got that name in that variable, I want to make it visible. So I'm going to put sheets, SHT name. So there's my variable coming in handy. What sheet? Oh, the one that I just found out matches the name of the link that was clicked. Then I'm going to put in my full stop, visible equals Excel sheet visible. So I'm going to make that sheet visible. Okay. Once it's visible, we need to go to it. So sheets, I could just copy and paste from above, but I'm underway now. Select, keep things simple for now. Now it's visible, select that sheet. Okay, let's test that this works. Before we go any further, let me come out of the editor here. And remember, the pairs sheet at the bottom is not visible. So let me click on pairs. And look at that, it unhides the sheet and takes us to it. So that is working. Let me right mouse click and hide a different sheet. Let me hide the oranges sheet this time. Go back to main and let's go back into the editor and look at another way that we can get this working. Let me right mouse click and hide a different sheet. This time I'll hide the apples sheet, go back to main and back into Visual Basic so that we can see a different way of unhiding a sheet from a hyperlink. Because the name of the link and the name of the sheet might not match. So what I'm going to do this time is comment out the previous approach and start a new one. So we're going to assign to SHT name the target.subaddress. So it's important here that I'm using subaddress and not address. Address is when you're linking to a separate workbook or to a different web page. But here I'm linking to a different sheet within the same workbook, which is a subaddress. Now, if you think about when you're writing formulas across different sheets, to cells on different sheets, think about its structure. You always have the name of the sheet followed by an exclamation mark followed by that cell reference. So what I need to do is the address or the subaddress that this link is going to, I want all of the characters up to the exclamation mark because that is the name of the sheet. Yeah, I can't rely on the name of the link being the same as the sheet, but the sheet name is in that address. It's the thing up to the exclamation mark. So I'm going to use that, but I need the left function because I want all the characters from that subaddress up to the exclamation mark. So the left function, just like you get in Excel normal, we have a VBA version. The string that we're taking from is the subaddress. But the length is the problematic bit. I don't know how many characters, it's up to the exclamation mark. So I'm going to use instring, instr. This is a function that will look for a string within a string, so text within some text, and return its starting position. Now the starting position of the actual search here is just from the first character, comma. String one is the string that you're looking within. And in this example, that's target.subaddress. So let me copy and paste that. Another comma leads me onto the string that I'm searching for within subaddress. And that is an exclamation mark. From here, I can close off that instring function and put minus one. Because we're looking for the length here for left to take. And the last character of the sheet name is one before the exclamation mark. Another close bracket for the left function, and we're done there. I can come back out of this and let's see if this is working. So let me minimize this. Remember, it's the Apple's sheet that I hid. So if I click on my Apple's hyperlink, it works. It has taken me to that sheet even though it was hidden. And if I hide the pineapple sheet, back to main, click on pineapples, it works. So that example was for even if the sheet has a different name, it will still be able to work, whereas my previous technique was ensuring that the sheets and the links are called the same thing for a slightly easier life and easier approach. Now, to take this one stage further, it might be that once your link from main has unhid and followed a link to that sheet, I have this back to main link. And if I click on that, it will work absolutely fine. But what you might want is the sheet to hide itself again. Now, it was hidden, it went to it, you click a link to go back, you know, fantastic. But if it was hidden to start with, you probably want it hidden again. Now, there's different techniques for that as well. I could use another follow hyperlink event in order to hide it, and that wouldn't be too tricky. But there may be other hyperlinks on this sheet, or maybe instead of following the hyperlink, maybe somebody just clicks from pineapples to oranges, or some, you know, maybe other sheets we have here in this situation, if it was more than just these. So they may not actually follow the hyperlink. So what I'm going to do instead is back into Visual Basic, and I'll pick on the Apples sheet here. So if I just double click on Apples in the Project Explorer on the left here to open up a code window for that. And then from the two drop downs at the top, I'll choose Worksheet from the first one. And from the second one, I'm going for Deactivate. So instead of follow hyperlink, I'm going for deactivate. So as soon as somebody leaves that sheet, whether that's via a hyperlink or whether it's via clicking somewhere, I don't care. They've just left that sheet. So I can delete that and come inside here, and a nice simple little bit of code, me.visible. I don't have to reference the sheet in the way I did a few moments ago, where I was capturing that variable and sht.name. I'm just referring to myself in this case. So me.visible equals Excel sheet hidden. So before we were doing visible, now we're hiding it. Now that is for the Apples sheet. And I might just leave that as Apples. But really we would copy and paste that onto the other sheet, oranges, pears, pineapples. But I'm going to leave that for a moment because I'm clicking around, don't need to get too crazy. I've only got four sheets here, so copying and pasting it wouldn't be like a huge step. If you have a few more, it may take a little bit more time, but nothing too crazy. And if you're doing this before we even get to this point, you can always copy the sheets. So remember, I did that to the Apples sheet. So let me hide Apples, go to the main sheet, click the link, which successfully unhides it and takes me back. But then if I click on back to main, to go back to main, Apples automatically hides itself. So that little bit of code, just add that little bit more so we can get a link to go to a hidden sheet, but then we can also get the sheet to hide itself when you exit that sheet, whether it be via hyperlink or by some other method. And we would copy that to the other sheets in this case, or those of your choosing. I hope you found this video useful. Please check out some of our other video tutorials on our YouTube channel and come check us out at computergaga.com.